Okay, so I just finished recording my first video, which was already up on YouTube. It's a Time Primal Flyers Expedition game, or five games. And I'm now going to jump into the Forge. I have played the Forge twice so far, just discovered it this past weekend, and both times I went 7. First time I went 7-0, second time I went 7-1. I've been having pretty good luck with it, so I don't know if it gets more difficult or if you get to the point where you can only have one loss. I'm not sure, but we'll see. Okay. I don't think I want the high profit. I think the Waystone is the most just universally good. Oh man, she's also cool. I just don't know how many sacrifice outlets there are in this forge. So, like I said, I've only done two. I think I'm gonna grab it though and just hope. This guy fits. You sacrifice, he comes back, you sacrifice again. I'm just gonna go for it. Corrupted comes back. I'm gonna go with this guy. Something I've discovered is, sorry, I just ate corn, so I probably have corn stuck in my teeth, which is why I just kinda picked at my tooth. There's corn cob. But, okay. Flying. Flying is very important, as I've discovered in Throne, not Throne, Forge. Mace, here we go. Here we go. I think I solely want to pick up this because I have the Waystone. I don't know if that's correct or not. I really like lifesteal. I think flying and lifesteal are like the two most important unit mechanics to have when you're doing the forge. Silence and stun a unit or entomb. I think I want the lower curve card. Some removal. Okay, summon the Wheeler gets flying this turn. Six drop. I'm always very impressed with this card. So I think I'm just gonna grab this card. I'm very impressed with, now I can pick up random strangers down the road and that would still be okay. Plus power equal to the highest student in my void. So it could potentially, but it's a one toughness is tough. I'll grab it just because my curve is high already. I have one stranger. I now have a second stranger that has an ability. Cowardice. I'm just looking to see if there's a way I can push this guy through. I think I'm gonna go with the cowardice is basically a removal. Strangers are deadly. I think the strangers are deadly. The other guy was really good, but strangers are deadly. Each copy of what can act. Nope, but how many weapons? The Christine attack. I don't have any decimate power abilities, so I think timidity is just the best choice. Can't block. I'm not interested, I don't think. I don't have any discard outlets. Sacrifice another unit to gain. Ooh, it's a sacrifice outlet, and it's a flyer. Lifesteal, 4 damage to a unit. I'm gonna try this one. It's corrupted, so it comes back when it dies. It clears away my opponent's flyers, sort of. I want the stranger, so I'm basically building a stranger deck. Just hope I don't come across any opponent's stranger deck. What's my curve looking like? 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 5, 5, 5, 5. 2, 2, 5. I think I needed some lower cost cards to fill out my curve. So I'm gonna grab the Oathbreaker instead of the Rampager. Two more cost. I think I'm gonna go with the cheaper one. Nah, more expensive one. Pledge, life's unblockable. It's tough. This is a very good end threat, I think. It'd be fine. I can just remove anything. Oh, excellent. Oh, wait. Dark Return, just basically a tutor. A 3-mana 3/3 that potentially has lifesteal. Did I grab the Oathbreaker? And if I reanimate him, if I reanimate him with my spell, Dark Return, I think that's worth it. Excellent. Love this stranger. Draw a unit from my void. I think this is better. More versatility. I'm gonna go with this one. Last pick. Plus one for each of the wielder's battle skills. I don't think I want that. Flying lifesteal. That'll really close the door. Kill each unit with fewer than two battle skills. So. A lot of my stuff is flying, war cry. I have these strangers to give battle skills. This gives lifesteal. Strangers are deadly. So they get deadly. That is tough. I think I'm gonna go with the always good card. I think this is like always gonna be good. Flying lifesteal. 6/6. Let's play. Well, what was that? What am I looking at? 10 minutes of deck building or drafting. So I just kind of boasted at the beginning that I have played this twice and had 7-0-7-1. This was interesting. I think I'll redraw. Okay. This is, oh dear. This is could be tragic. Okay, excellent. I drew a castable card. This could potentially be absolutely awful. Did I put any cheap cards in my deck? Excellent. Excellent. I think I really just want to draw power. Thank you. Okay. So, fingers crossed, they don't play anything. Excellent. Just what I wanted. Well, this could be a real quick forge, guys. Oh, it's just a summon ability. Wow. For some reason, I thought this was a, it just statically gets buffed. Okay. I don't think I'm gonna. This is gonna be a sad forge. You know what? That's fine. I think I'm gonna no block. Just because I'm holding back these guys, I think that's worth it. Oh boy. Now I have some choices. Mithril Mace, take out one of them. Or I think I'll just play this guy. And I think I totally stay back on block. Okay. I would really like to go runner power. You know, or you could just do that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, put me to 2. This can end up being. Oh no. Well. Here's the thing, if I play the mace. Fortunately, everything costs 5. What is this? 2? This might be an. Oh, man. What do I do to get out of this? I can only play one thing out of my hand. I think it's gonna be this one. I think that was the best play. Because now I block. Oh, no. Well, so much for that dream. This could be a really. That's all right. That's all right. Let's just go 7-0. Let's also edit this sad record. I am 0 and 1. Why didn't I record my first two Forge games? Maybe streaming is making me nervous. Let's see. Let's draw the right half of my deck. This looks like the right half of my deck. Am I on the play also? Excellent. Play the life. Oh no, I'm not in the play. Oh no. I might have been a little too ambitious with this curve. Okay. So next turn I can potentially play this, attack. Oh, you guys probably all just saw how I totally messed that up. I played a sigil instead of playing my untapped source. Okay, well on the bright side, the opponent is running out of cards in hand. Okay, never punished. Good to know. Let's just do this. End turn. Next turn, I think I'll play this stranger and then get in there. Nice. I'll play this and I think I'm gonna get in there. I think I'm okay losing any of the guys I lose. Excellent. The one I was most scared about losing was this stranger, because I think this stranger is the most powerful that I got. Oh, great. Wait. Oh, whoops. I meant to put that back in my hand. That's okay. All right, well now the deck is looking a lot more convincing. I'd say. But I think I did read that about the Forge, that if you lose, they get easier on you. So. Oh no, they got a free card. Killer, Lifesteal, Warcry. So, deadly? No. I think I'm just gonna... Honestly, do I just play this guy? Knock out one of the blockers and slam? Let's make a big, big, big boy. And yeah, I'll push them through. Yeah. It's fine. I think this is fine. This is fine. So next turn I can play this guy. Well, actually I don't need to worry about my life too much. So what's this? I can't attack. Play this. Sacrifice this. Killer you. Send him in. Excellent. All right, well, at least we're getting one chest today. Oh, this is so much more stressful. Having already gotten one loss. But on the bright side, that was a pretty convincing second game. Maybe the first game was just unlucky. Let's check out. Whoops. Here, let's go to the second game. Third game, I guess. Record is now 1-1. Huh. Oh, hum diddly. Missing a color. I think I would have kept that if I had one of each color, but oh my goodness. Doing me like this. Just give me one color, huh? Oh man. Well, at least that's a pretty good removal spell. Gosh. I feel real silly grabbing these situational cards. I better just go runner, 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 power. Oh. Would have been excellent if this guy had lifesteal. Can I have some of that power, please? Well, this is gonna be a sad, sad forge, unfortunately. Mean, you gotta be kidding me. Choose a card to discard. Well, I'm a long ways away from her, but I think this is honestly the least impactful. Just get rid of the cowardice. Making it so we can't block. Whatever. Well, now I feel silly. I just got rid of my one and only. All right. Come at me, bro. No blocks. They're definitely gonna have a follow-up. Oh, no follow-up. Maybe we're back in this some miraculous way. Now I really wish I had kept that cowardice. I feel big silly. Woof. I think I'm just gonna send him in. Excellent. Excellent. Just like we drew it up. Okay. So play you, attack, make a 1/1. Okay. We might be stabilizing. Okay. What do I do here? Definitely play this. I think I. This is just gonna be the most long-term value. Do I just hit with everything? I mean, if you let my lifestealer survive, I feel great. No. I'll just go in like this. Okay. I'm feeling pretty good now. Greatest power. Think I'm just gonna Get in there with everything. Oh, that was silly. I should have played this game. Oh well. Sorry. I'll play my Marsh Dragon, which will sacrifice a unit. Which will increase the Waystone. So I think I did mess up. I probably should have played the Merciless Stranger. Maybe. I don't really know. Either way, I think this game is going all right. I think now I just attack with... Actually, you know what? I think I'll attack with everybody. I mean, if they want to trade with my cultists... Okay, cool. I'm just going to make another one. So I think I'm doing all right. Recovered. Recovered from the problem. I think this is lethal. Yeah, this is definitely lethal. Well, we are coming back in there after. I'm still not super happy with it. Losing game one was definitely very nerve-wracking. I was really nervous this would just be a straight 0-2 gauntlet or forge. And the two games we won were a little close, a little too close for comfort. But, I think I'm going to keep this just because I know how many 5 drops I have in the deck. I also feel silly picking this card. This is pretty good, actually. Okay. Well, if you're going to give me the Waystone also, I'd rather have him die and then come back with +1/+1 and lifesteal. Also, I would not have wanted to attack this guy into a 2-1. Let's get in there. Excellent. Play my cultist maker. You know, it makes me sad. I think I'm only going to attack with this guy just because, well, fine. When the Waystone comes down on turn 5, it does feel pretty alright. I think I'm going to do this to speed up the Waystone. Now I feel silly. Thank you. Not helpful. No, I still don't want. I was thinking if I was maybe gonna grab the Silenced Stranger for my Void, but not worth it. Hey, guess what? Get absolutely wrecked. So power off the top is good because I get to play my boom boom as long as it's undepleted. Thank you. I really wonder what this player has in their hand, having 8 power, 4 cards in hand, and nothing to do. Really curious. So if they don't have lifesteal, they just lose in like 3 turns to the Waystone. Well, now I'm sad. My whole master plan of reanimating him to get to lifesteal. Oh well. I may not have done my plan, but we did get the win, so I will take it. I'm feeling a little better. Feeling a little better about this Forge masterpiece. I've at least got one gold chest. Not the greatest, considering entry was 2,500. But we'll see. We'll see. I guess I'll redraw. Well, oh no, don't do one damage to him, don't do it. Oh, thank goodness. Well, hopefully I draw some action. Or I could just Or I could just, keep drawing sigils. Oh, come on. Oh, thank goodness. Thank you for being garbage AI. Thank you. I really want to get this ultimate so I don't just die to another one of these guys. Which is why I played his ultimate instead of playing the life-stealing Warcry. It was also more mana efficient, so. Incredible. Now I can double spell. Feels absolutely great. Well, I'm feeling pretty good about where we are. Still not out of the woods because our opponent still has four cards in hand. Ooh, a cowardice. Come on, cowardice. I think I just go in with everything. I don't want to be held back forever by this. So, do your worst. All right, and now I'm clear to play my life-stealing revenge. I think I will attack with them all. Okay, they're not all of them. There's no point in attacking on the ground because they've got bigger ground guys. Now the question is, yeah, I think I play him. I'll sacrifice the 1/3. I think I'm feeling okay. Lots of nightfall. Oh, excellent. I think I will do that. But you don't have charge, do you? No. Attack you for 6. I will play my guy. And I will hold this sigil. I don't think there's any point in playing it. A blocks. Oh. I think you're still dead though. I don't think this goes wrong at all. All right. Moving up in the world. 4 and 1. Which I would like to get at least 2 more wins. Gold chests, 2 gold chests. Third win. Incredible. So, here we go. Relentless Onslaught. So, this is probably going to be Burn. I imagine I have some Seers in my future. I also imagine this Life Speaker is not for the world, long for the world. But what can you do? Well, I would have loved to have drawn a unit there to take advantage before they kill him or her. Relentless Onslaught. You are not as relentless as I envisioned you being. I envisioned red in my future. Hey, that's fine. Because guess what? Sigil ability. Attack. Now I gotta start thinking, who am I going to take down with this Mithril Mace? Answer: a Copper Hall recruit. Now, actually, oh. Well, now I feel like a big dum-dum. Well, they still trade it anyways. So it costs 5. I thought it was a 5-power weapon. The AI is, of course, the AI, so they blocked. But, well, definitely taking you out. Oh, come on. Okay. I need something to do. I think I described the 4/4. Making it a 5/5. Really, really wish he still had his ability. Reclaim. Woof. You know what? If you are all about onslaughting. I mean, that's fine. Oh, thank the Lord. Who will I take out? Probably the flyer. Because now I get to play my boom boom. Hopefully they don't have anything for them. If they just have like a permafrost, that would be sad times. I don't think there's any value in playing it or holding it, so. Okay, same name as my other units. Onslaught. Okay, well, attack. Guess what? No box, sure. Oh, come on. Well, I mean, AI doing AI things. I guess I'll take it. Update the record to 5-1. Well, thanks, AI. Going easy on me after drafting a really bad Forge deck. Thank you for going easy on me. Let me know if you guys like the Forge Masters content, because it's definitely a series I do not need to continue. I don't think I can keep this. I don't think it has enough. If it's something you enjoy, if it's not, I'm planning on at least to start off with playing every single play mode. Every single format, I guess you would call it. I might do Gauntlet. Definitely going to do Expedition and Throne. I'm going to play Lifestealer. I'm just going to hold my Beetle back to block your Lifestealer. I mean, excellent. Less than excellent. Very less than excellent. Well, if there's anything I definitely want to draw here, it is power. Hopefully the opponent is running out of steam. I am going to get in there. Then I'm going to take 6, but then I'm going to play some good Valkyries that hopefully stabilize. Wow. That is a card. Quick draw, not what I was hoping for. I'll hold them both back so I can throw you in front of you. Is it time to give up on the stranger? No. No. Cancel. Block. So if I draw a sigil, then I can double spell. Oh, excellent. Strangers are deadly. I don't think I can take all this damage, though. So I think I'm just gonna have to block them up. Oh, what now? You had exalted? Well. Oh, I'm just dead. I need to draw The guy that says you can't attack. I mean, that's impressive. I don't think this actually saves me, though. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I don't think this, yeah. Well, it doesn't matter. But, well, unfortunately, we did not get, oh, don't want to click on that. Unfortunately, we did not get the 7. Oh, or 7. 1. We got a 5-2, which was less than ideal. But let's claim these prizes at least. You know, you never know. You never know. These chests might upgrade. Let's see what we get. See, look at that. Just like that. Oh my goodness. Better lucky than good, I guess. So I did just about win back my stuff just on pure luck. Win back my earnings. Let's crack these packs, shall we? And see how much shift stone we get. Pay 2 and discard a card to give Skyguard +1/+1 and draw a card. Interesting. Pretty good, actually, I'd say. 2-cost, 2-2 flyer. Pretty good. Come on, mythic. No, not quite. Pay 3 and exhaust the boy to give another unit +3 and quick draw this turn. Not bad. Let's see what I got. 42. So now I've got enough. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. $7.99. Whatever. Well, thanks for watching this first episode of Forge Masters. Sorry it wasn't the 7x like I previously had, unrecorded, undocumented, the one that got away. But, well, hopefully I'll see you guys in the next video, and let me know how you think about this series or what you'd like to see, what Eternal content you'd like to see. I can go through my collection, play different formats, but I'd like to try and stay free-to-play and see what kind of trouble I can get into as a free-to-play Eternal player. So, well, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you, hopefully, in future videos.